Best supports are no supports. In today's video, I'll dive into designing parts for 3D printing to achieve higher strength and to avoid support structures. Using clever tricks, parts can be easily redesigned so that they don't need support structures, resulting in faster print times and less waste. Welcome to JanTec Engineering. Thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring part of this video. When scrolling through the most popular videos and comments, I noticed two main things. Everyone wants their parts to be as strong as possible, and we all hate supports. I've experimented with specialized engineering filaments and various techniques like infill injection, non-planar printing and release agents for effortless support removal. But before we can even think about 3D printing, we need a 3D design. I'm currently building a universal testing machine, and through that I've learned valuable insights into achieving stronger, support-free prints. Of course, I didn't come up with all these tricks myself. I used various online resources and got inspired by models from talented designers. You'll find all the links in the video description. Oh, and thanks to Prusa Research for sponsoring my new studio. I'm currently doing the renovations and will soon share more about this new place. To be able to avoid supports, we first need to understand why and when they are needed. Most 3D printers handle overhangs up to about 45 degrees without an issue, but anything beyond that, or long horizontal bridges, will just collapse into spaghetti. We have to keep in mind that our FDM 3D printers build up parts layer by layer, and each layer needs a solid foundation to stick to. Knowing these limitations is key to optimizing our designs. Unsupported holes. It happens quite often that you have unsupported holes on the underside of your 3D prints, but there's a neat trick to avoid the need for support structures. I first saw this in printed components from the Prusa MK4 machines, and Hydro Research provides design instructions for it. The idea is to create bridges that support the circle instead of printing it mid-air. For my universal testing machine, I made such a bearing block. There's no way to orient it differently on the print bed, and with this trick, no supports are necessary. Here's how to do it. Create a new sketch on the surface of the hole you want to support. Project a circle and add tangents to the top, bottom, left and right, just as I'm doing here. Make sure they're constrained horizontally or vertically. Then select either top and bottom or left and right and extrude by twice the layer height you want to print with. For instance, 2 times 0.2 mm equals 0.4 mm. Next, extrude the remaining sections by one layer height and the hole is supported. When slicing your model, you can see that it works exactly as intended. Sacrificial layers. But there's an even easier way, as long as you're willing to sacrifice an additional layer. By extruding a thin amount of material into the hole, exactly one layer thick, you trick the printer into printing a tiny overhang, which is easy to handle. As the name suggests, this layer gets removed after printing using a drill or knife. Technically, this could be considered support material, but let's be honest, this is way more efficient than the regular supports we all know from our slicers. This technique isn't even limited to holes. In fact, you can support any shape like hexagons, often used for bowls or nuts. By the way, I'm using Autodesk Fusion 360, as these are designs I do in my student job at university, but of course you can apply these tricks in any CAD program you like. Bridging layers. Taking the previous ideas a step further, we can support almost any shape using a clever arrangement of bridges. Depending on your print settings and cooling fan, different bridge lengths can be printed reliably. A great example is this main body from the Open Flexure Microscope project. This entire part is printed without any support structures, and I think it's mind-blowing how they designed it. The top holder is supported by a clever arrangement of bridges that stack on top of each other, supporting one another and resulting in a perfect circular shape. I recommend checking this design out. You can download it from the link below and load it into your slicer. I don't have an example where I used this exact technique in one of my own designs, but I thought it was too cool not to share. Let me know what you think in the comments. Oh, and I'd really appreciate if you could subscribe to my channel. So far, only a small percentage of my viewers are subscribed, and it would really help me out. Thanks a lot. Horizontal holes. Let's change the orientation of the part to have the hole in a standing position. When slicing it regularly, the printer does this, not what we wanted. The problem is that the slope at the top of a circle becomes steeper and steeper and eventually exceeds what our printers can handle. As mentioned earlier, most FDM-free printers are limited to a certain overhang angle, typically around 45 degrees. When building up the circle, the angle increases from 0 degrees to 90 degrees. So if you print a vertical hole, the layers in the top section will droop, resulting in a messy look and dimensional inaccuracy. To avoid this, we can change the circle to a teardrop shape. This gives us a constant slope of 45 degrees, making the parts fit as intended. Hydra Research once again provides a nice tutorial for this in their guide, and I've used it in my own project. Design own supports. And if none of this helps, you can also design your own custom supports to make them more efficient, print faster, and make life easier for people who download your models. To do this, find the best orientation of the component and then add tiny contact areas 0.4 or 0.8 mm thick. You can either connect them directly to the part or leave a gap of around 0.2 mm for easy removal. I recommend checking out Slant3D's videos and looking at the printed parts from the Positron project where they used custom designed supports. One additional trick I learned from Slant3D: you can export SLA generated supports from your Prusa slicer, which are quite different from the usual FDM auto supports. I sliced the 45 degree rotated benchy for the Prusa SL1, exported the object and support structures as STL, and then sliced them again for my Prusa MK4S. The result is interesting. You might say, that's brilliant. But no, that's brilliant, the sponsor of today's video. I guess you're all here to learn something new and improve your skills, right? Whether it's mastering 3D printing, electronics, or designing something like the testing machine I'm building today, what really makes a difference is how well you understand the concepts behind it. That's where Brilliant comes in. It's an interactive learning app that helps you become a better thinker and problem solver with thousands of visual, interactive lessons in math, science, programming, data analysis, and AI. As an electrical engineering student, I love Brilliant's new courses on digital circuits and programming. I actually relied on it to prepare for a Python exam at university. What stood out was how different it felt from just watching videos or reading theory. Every course is built around doing. You're solving problems, playing with simulations, and building your understanding step by step. It's all super visual and intuitive and way more effective than passive learning. So if you're into engineering, programming, or just love figuring out how things work, Brilliant is honestly one of the best tools you can add to your workflow. You can try everything Brilliant has to offer completely free for 30 days at brilliant.org/JanTec Engineering, and if you decide to keep going, you'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Just use the link in the description or scan the QR code right here. Let's continue with the second part of this video on how to make parts stronger. Part orientation. A huge mistake, especially when you're just starting out, is choosing the wrong part orientation. Let's take a bracket as an example. It can be printed in two orientations, standing or lying flat. When applying force to it, the standing version breaks much more easily. It takes significantly less force to tear it apart. The reason is that FDM printers build up parts layer by layer, and the adhesion between these layers is typically the weakest spot. Over time, I've tested various filaments by printing tensile testing specimens in both laying and standing orientations. For all materials, the standing orientation was noticeably weaker, while the flat lying orientation was up to 3 times stronger. So always make sure to understand where the forces apply on your part and orient it accordingly in your CAD program. Split model. You might have heard that increasing the number of perimeters helps improve part strength, and that's true, but it also increases print time and uses more material. For larger prints, where only specific regions need to be stronger or stiffer, we can split the object into multiple components. Each component can be printed with different settings, like more perimeters or higher infill density, exactly where it matters. Import the model into your slicer and select Split to Parts. This shows you the multiple objects we created earlier, and by right-clicking on them, we can assign unique print settings. This bracket, for instance, gets reinforced at the connection with additional parameters. I also saw a similar approach in the shoe designs by Cloudberry, where they split the model to create unique mechanical properties and looks. Fillets. So, is your part strong enough? That depends on how the internal forces, or stress, flow through the geometry. Stress lines are a good way to visualize this. They show how forces travel through a solid object when it's under load. I'm not a mechanical engineer, but it's quite intuitive, kind of like electric field lines. Stress tends to concentrate in places where these lines are squeezed together. This usually happens at sharp internal corners or sudden transitions. That's why you should always add fillets to reduce stress concentration. Rounded transitions help distribute force more evenly across your part, making it less prone to cracking or breaking, especially under load. So as a rule of thumb, avoid sharp corners and use fillets wherever stress is likely to build up. If you made it this far in the video, you're awesome. Just like my channel members you can see here. And Brilliant, the sponsor of this video. Click the link below for a 30-day free trial and 20% discount on your annual premium subscription. I hope you enjoyed this type of content and learned something new. Make sure you're subscribed and let me know your thoughts in the comments. See you next time, here at JanTec Engineering.